This Pelimage or image house, 27 feet in height, had once upon a time contained an upright figure of the Buddha. Only the base remains today, with its chamber stripped of all the precious offerings buried before erecting the statue. This is the Uposathagara or chapter house of the Jetavana complex, residential quarters for monks known as Panchavasa. An inscription of King Mahinda IV, dated somewhere towards the end of the 10th century, speaks thus: "Whatever remains after repairs have been effected at the site of the great stone statue Ruanpaha, the chapter house at the Abhayatura Mahasaya, at the shrine of the sacred Bo tree, shall be kept as communal property." Recent archaeological excavations at the site have also revealed other features, such as assembly halls and temple buildings. At the entrance to the residential quarters of the chief priest is a guard stone. S.M. Burrows, in his archaeological report in the late 19th century, states, "The door guardian stones, standing over 5 feet high, is unrivaled in excellence of preservation and delicacy of finish." This is the best example of a moonstone, a creation unique to Sri Lankan sculpture. It can be seen at the foot of the steps leading to the Panchavasa or the monks' quarters. This is a kind of stupa rare in Sri Lanka, with steps leading to the upper stories, and reflects strong and mystic Mahayanic influences. There is evidence supported by finds that the entire stupa, stone slabs and statues, have all been painted with locally produced lime-based paint. One such paint-making center with engraved depressions for mixing has been discovered and restored at Abhayagiri. The Sannipata Sala or assembly hall for monks facing the Abhayagiri Dagaba is the largest of its kind in Anuradhapura and may have accommodated a congregation of over 5,000. In the Mahamega Gardens, there are the remains of a sanatorium for aging bhikkhus. Dharani Griha, as these terraced edifices are known, may have been chambers where rituals and occult practices were performed and reflect the Mahayanic tradition represented by the Abhayagiri chapter. Abhisheka Mandapa, the ceremonial anointing hall. There is something very weird about these remnants of ancient luxury hidden in the lonely forest, observed Henry W. Cave, writing in 1896. There are so many, he continued, and they vary so much in architectural treatment that they must have added greatly to the aspect of the city. We cannot help reflecting, too, that the famous baths of the Roman emperors were constructed contemporaneously with these, and that while those of Caracalla and Diocletian, being built of brick, have crumbled now beyond repair, the picturesque and elegant baths of Duttagamini and their beautiful terraces and stairways of granite can with little trouble be restored to their pristine condition. Cave was unaware that these elegant baths were built almost exclusively for the use of Buddhist monks in a city wholly dedicated to a faith whose goal is nirvana. There are other stupas in the Abhayagiri Vihara complex. One such is the Lankarama stupa, which originally had a conical roof covering. The community of monks had enormously increased with the popularity of the new religion, and Duttagamini made their welfare his chiefest care, erecting the Loha Pasada, known as the Brazen Palace, for their accommodation. In the words of the great chronicle Mahavamsa, in this palace there were 1,000 dormitories, having windows with ornaments which are bright as eyes. Ruanvelisaya, the gold dust dark ever with its purity of line and contours of classical spareness, symbolizes the spirit of Anuradhapura, one of the most beautiful chapters in the history of mankind's quest for peace and harmony on earth. To the southeast of Anuradhapura is this hill rising from a range bursting out of the plain from practically sea level. Ritigalakanda, the rock like a long pole, is steeped in history and legend. Once upon a time, the abode of the Yakkas, indigenous tribals of prehistoric Lanka, Ritigala enters recorded history in 307 BC, still not totally free of myth, when Mahavamsa records a great battle here between the rebel prince Pandukabha and his uncles. 1,000 years later, Ritigala becomes a hermitage for an order of bhikkhus, referred to as Pansakulika, who had taken a vow of extreme asceticism. It received royal patronage, and the numerous ruins which litter the entire hill range and its many once inhabited caves afford ample support to the story of the ancient importance of the site. For many years, Ritigala lay wrapped in a taboo that no mortal should step within its dark and mysterious precincts, because the spirits of the now vanished Yakka tribe protected their ancestral abode from intruders. James Mantle, a British surveyor, broke the taboo and entered Ritigala somewhere between 11th of May and 10th of July 1872. For the British civil servants of the 19th century, Stationed in the harsh and unhealthy climate of the north central province of Sri Lanka, Ritigala offered the tantalizing promise of a sanctuary.